What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I hope everyone is doing well this morning, afternoon, or night, whatever time it is, because, you know, today, I got one question for you guys, and that is, who's horny for thorny, right? I can't say that without, like, laughing, man. It's just so stupid, but I am pretty horny for thorny, and I was going to say, but that's kind of fucked up. No, I'm just excited to be checking out this song, which is Thornhill, Casanova. Man, I really like Thornhill. The last album, The Dark Pool, was chef's kiss. Double chef's kiss, man. It was so good. I love their take of metalcore with like ambience and like almost like post-metal and industrial vibes. It's very unique, man. And with Casanova, I heard that, you know, they're going to be expanding on some of the more softer ideas that they had in The Dark Pool, which has me really excited. You know, I'm not just a breakdown boy or guitar solo boy. I also like some ambience and chill stuff. So we'll see what Casanova has to offer, but that's enough chit chat. So let's fucking do it. Okay, still Genty, nice. Taking the look of this video, man. Okay. Cool feedback transition. I feel like we're going to get like a pop rock track with Gent elements. Okay, yeah. 2 seconds ain't enough. Judging by the style of how these guys look right now. Late 90s, early 2000s kind of vibes. Oh, okay, yeah. Going for like a hooky grunge vibe. Drum patterns are fucking sick like usual, man. Okay. Damn. Love this chorus. Alright. He's so seductive right now, man. He's embracing the horny for thorny meme, man. Oh, okay. Just realized we were getting a breakdown groove. I was just chit-chatting too much. Nice, second verse is different. Really going for that dreamy, seductive sound with this song, man. Ooh. Oh, please tell me the second verse is a build up to a breakdown, man. Dizzy Palmore, come on. Oh! Oh, wow! Is this even Thornhill anymore? Holy shit! Okay. Chino has entered the chat. Oh, that melody's nice. Oh, it's going to smash again. Let's go. Come on. Okay, we're getting some feedback with this one. Oh, Damn, very different. Yeah, I think there's a lot to talk about with this one. So, yeah, let's talk about it. Okay, so this is clearly a much different direction for Thornhill, and I don't know how fans will enjoy this because this sounds a lot different than Dark Pool and like even their earlier stuff too. You know, I feel like they really abandoned the metalcore, prog metalcore vibes that they were going for in favor of a more pop rock, shoegaze vibe with this track alone, but with some djent elements. So, you know, they still incorporated the heavy breakdowns and the djent guitars and stuff and the busy drum work that is very Thornhill, but, you know, I would say 70% of the song is really at heart, you know, industrial shoegaze and 90s grunge. It's very, very different. I think they pull it off. I think they pull it off really well, but it is going to take some time to really warm up to the sound because this is clearly not Dark Pool like 2.0 or anything. This is a much different sound, and to have a sudden sound change so soon is a little bit tough to digest, but for what this song is, it delivered. So let's go through the pros and cons. Number one pro is that they perfectly blended in the 90s grunge shoegaze with djent. And I've never heard it sound so unique. You know, when there's djent elements and like, I know there's other bands that have done this before, like Ocean Grove, for example, that are mixing like a lot of 90s influence with like djent, but I feel like this really had a lot of heavy moments. Like this was a heavy song, but it also had those dreamy soundscapes that we're so used to, shoegaze, and it just seemed to work really well with those chunky guitars, but with those, I think the vocally is what made this song really stand out because it was just a lot more ethereal. So that'll be pro number two, is just the vocals are so good. You know, obviously Thornhill is a band that has strong vocals. They always have. But, you know, gone are kind of the harsh vocals and the screams that we're so used to with metalcore. And honestly, me being a little bit older in the scene, I'm kind of like wanting fresh sounds in the scene. That's what I'm looking for, and that's what I kind of tend to criticize. If it just sounds like the same old stuff that I've heard for like, you know, for the past decade, I tend to write it off. This sounds very refreshing, and vocally it's so strong because his take at this metalcore is refreshing, where it's like I said, very Chino, it's very Deftones, and almost like 90s grunge, like almost like the Cranberries or something a little bit. Like, it's weird. It's very weird. And growing up with 90s music, it feels nostalgic, but also modern at the same time. And that's what I mean about them delivering. Another pro is just like the structure to the song was actually really cool. You know, Thornhill's a band that's always been playing around with structures. Like with the Dark Pool, they really show that they had like some progressive elements in their music. You know, some songs like go on for like 6 minutes, and other 4 minute songs have unorthodox structures. So I like that. And with this song, you know, they followed like almost a pop rock structure, which I thought was kind of cool, but they flipped it on its head, right? The first verse had two sections. Maybe, you know, the second section was a pre-chorus. I don't know, but I'll just say two sections in the first verse before we got into that shoegaze chorus. So already right there and then, it's not, you know, a typical structure, right? It's just not one verse that goes into a chorus. And then the second verse, completely different. It essentially was just a build-up to get to that guitar solo. The song also ended with a breakdown, and like we also had a bridge that had a breakdown. So that's what I mean. Like, the song had a pretty interesting structure for pop rock almost sounding structure, right? But yeah, another pro is just the musicianship. These guys are really good. So I'm glad that this song is trying new things, new sounds, but they still didn't sacrifice the djent guitars, right? They didn't completely abandon their DNA like entirely, right? So we still got some heavy down-tuned guitars, some chunky riffs, some chunky grooves that sounded very similar to what we're used to with Thornhill. Also drumming, right? Drumming was pretty intricate. I know drums in this band are pretty like intricate with fills and stuff and like some odd beats, and it's not like, you know, typical beats that you're like can easily pick apart, right? And that's what I enjoy with this song and just like every other Thornhill song. That being said, let's move on to the cons. You know, I think they actually did a really good job with the song. The cons is that this is definitely a sound change, and it's, you know, it's not like it doesn't feel like a slow evolution to the Dark Pool. It feels pretty sudden. This is like, holy crap, like, is this even Thornhill anymore? So it's going to take some time to adjust to it. That being said, like, I did enjoy the song. I'm wondering what else they can pull with like their new direction, right? Because, like, honestly, I think the Dark Pool was really good. That I hope that they don't abandon so many things that were special about that album. Like, they had a lot of good synth work and a lot of good soundscapes that I hope that they incorporate with their new singles. Because if they abandon all that in favor for 90s grunge, I'm going to be disappointed with the album. Because, you know, it's taken a lot of strengths that they had and just, you know, disregarding it and trying new things. Which is fine, but also I like the new things, but also bringing in elements to what made their music so special to begin with, right? But yeah, like, that's my only con. It's not really a major con because this song was different, but I think they delivered it, man. But yeah, that's my thoughts on Thornhill's new track. I'm curious to know what your thoughts are, so comment down below. Spice up my life. What'd you guys think of the new song? I'd love to know people's opinion on this. Also, if you got to this point in the video and haven't clicked off yet, then I appreciate the shit out of you, man. Feel free to hit that subscribe button. Feel free to leave a like if you enjoyed the video. But other than that, thank you for tuning in. Till next time. Peace.